guys, this is Kriti Bhatnagar, your legal reasoning educator at 12 Minutes to CLAT. Now guys, as you all know, more than 50,000 students write the CLAT examination. How do you make sure that you get the best rank so that you get to your dream law school? Without further ado, let's start the video. So guys, first of all, step one is understanding what you have to do in the next 8 months. So there are three things that you have to do in the next 8 to 9 months. If you do these three things, I guarantee that you will definitely clear the examination. Number one is going to be your syllabus completion of the 5 sections of CLAT examination. Number two is writing mock test. Very, 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 very important. If you're not writing mocks and just completing your syllabus, it will be very difficult to clear the exam. And last is going to be mock analysis. If you do these three things, I guarantee that you will clear the CLAT examination. So let's understand how to do these three things. Step one is going to be to make sure to understand the point of view of the examination. How do you make sure the point of view of the examination is looking at the previous year question papers. Now, whenever you get time, and that should be soon, for example, upcoming Sunday, you can pick up the last 3 years question paper of CLAT, CLAT 2024, CLAT 2023, and CLAT 2022. If you wish to, you can also pick up CLAT 2021 and analyze the question paper. Now, what do I mean by analysis of the question paper? I mean that look at all the 5 sections of that question paper and understand how much of it are you able to grasp. For example, if I am at your place and I have picked up the CLAT 2024 question paper and I see the English section, I can see vocabulary questions, comprehension based questions, I am able to answer. But for example, tone of the passage, wherein there is a little technical question asked, I am not able to answer those questions. Keep a copy beside you and write these things down. Vocabulary questions, I was able to answer. Tone of the passage, not able to answer. So that I will know what do I know already and what do I have to prepare better, right? For example, I go to the legal reasoning section, I see that I'm not able to attend anything. So I can understand that I have not yet prepared for legal reasoning. Except the current affairs part, make sure that you analyze all these different 4 sections of the question paper to understand what kind of questions will be put forward to you. Now, step number 2 is going to be syllabus completion. Now, there are 2 ways to complete your syllabus. One could be a guided preparation. You can enroll in courses at 12 Minutes to CLAT and we will make sure that your syllabus is completed. Through this, you will not have to look at different sources and prepare for the exam. So a lot of your time will be not consumed in looking for sources and trying to complete your syllabus. You can just attend the classes, which are generally in the evening, and on the weekends you can give mocks, and that way your syllabus will be completed. So a new batch has been launched, which is Vijay Bhava Plus. If any of you wish to enroll in the same, you can use code KRITIB and get the maximum discount on the courses. And we will see you in the classes if you wish to attend the same. Now, if you wish to do self-preparation, then there are 5 sections in the CLAT examination. First is going to be English. How do you prepare the English section? You have to prepare 3 things. First, comprehension-based question. Secondly, vocabulary-based questions. Third, tone of the passage and figures of speech. If you prepare these 3 things, you can look up onto Google, YouTube for help and prepare the section and make sure you practice a lot of comprehension based question. Second is going to be current affairs. Current affairs also requires 3 things to be completed. You can complete a month's current affairs through a compendium that you want to refer to. Secondly, making sure that you read the newspaper daily. Ma'am, why should I read the newspaper when I'm doing the compendium? So that it also helps with your reading speed. And if by chance you miss something, you can cover it up with the newspaper's help. So make sure that you're doing time-bound newspaper reading of like 45 minutes to 1 hour. Thirdly, make sure that you are practicing questions from websites like GK Today or any other website that you prefer. So that your current affairs syllabus is getting revised as well. third is going to be legal reasoning, which I teach. Now, in legal reasoning section, you have to prepare 5 subjects: law of torts, criminal law, constitutional law, contracts law, and miscellaneous laws. All these subjects, if you wish, you can also enroll in specific legal reasoning course in 12 minutes to CLAT, in which we will be covering the whole syllabus for legal reasoning, as there is no book which covers all the important points of these 5 laws. Or else, if you wish to, then you can Google the topics and study through that. Next is going to be critical reasoning. So how do you prepare for critical reasoning section? Is through practice. Make sure that you understand what is inference, what is tone of the passage, what is strengthening, weakening, and look at the previous law question papers so that you understand the point of view of the examiner. And then as you practice, your critical reasoning section will get better. Lastly, coming to quantitative aptitude. Now, a lot of students are scared of this section, thinking that it does not weigh a lot, and therefore there is no point in studying a lot for it, and also maths is something we don't like. But guys, understand that when you want to get into the top ranks, maths is that particular section which makes you get that rank. So for example, the toppers generally have all these 4 sections well versed with: English, legal, logical, and current affairs. But maths is something that everybody is struggling with. So if you make sure that you have practiced enough for quantitative aptitude, at least getting 5 to 6 marks in that section, then your rank will definitely get better to a larger scale. So make sure that you complete your quant syllabus, ratio, proportion, percentage, basic math till class 10th. And make sure if you are weak in math section, then you take out at least 2 days in a week in which you thoroughly practice math section. And that way you can complete your maths ka syllabus. So these are the 5 subjects to be covered in the CLAT exam. Now, coming to the most important step, which is writing a mock test and mock analysis. Now, make sure that you practice at least 1 to 2 mocks a week. If you want, you can buy the mocks from 12 minutes to CLAT or any other website that you wish to practice from. And make sure that you're practicing at least 1 to 2 mocks a week. Now, after you practice a mock, for example, you fix 2 days, Wednesday and Sunday. On Wednesday, you give a mock from 2 to 4 p.m. and on Sunday, you give a mock from 2 to 4 p.m. After 4 p.m., take a break of 15 to 30 minutes maximum. No more than that, because else you will forget what reasoning did you apply to that particular question. I know it is a tedious task, but success requires hard work, and we are not afraid to do hard work, right? So make sure that within a gap of 15 to 30 minutes, you sit down for your mock analysis. It will not take more than 1.5 to 2 hours if you are doing it properly, and analyze your mocks so that you know which section you are lagging at. Now, once you analyze your mocks, you will realize what are the 2 sections that you are lagging behind at. The 2 sections that you have scored the lowest at. For example, quants and current affairs, you're scoring the lowest. So in that particular case, in the coming week, make sure that you're practicing more of maths and current affairs so that your marks increase in those 2 sections in the upcoming mock. That way, your mock score will also keep on increasing. Any question that you answer wrongly, keep a mock test copy with you so that you can write down in that copy what mistakes you are making. Now, certain important tips for all of you. So the first tip is going to be that always think from the point of view of the examiner. A lot of times students tell me, "Ma'am, I sit for the mock exam, but my mock scores are stuck." Why is that? That is because you are still answering from your own perspective to the question. Like for example, like you are writing a mock test in which one of the questions says that A is a person who went to B's house, cut a tree, could not take the tree out of the house. Has he committed theft? Now the answer is yes, he has committed theft. But sometimes we get emotional. Ma'am, but this is not theft. He did not take the tree outside the house. He did not get anything through this. So stop You cannot be emotional when you're writing an exam. You have to think from the point of view of the examiner that has set up the examination. Mostly in English and critical reasoning also we lag. For example, we think it from our point of view that what should happen, but we must understand that what was the point of view of the examiner. How do you understand that? Through practicing more mocks and understanding why your option was wrong and why the examiner's option was right, and then applying that reasoning the next time that you write a mock. Second major important tip is going to be make a to-do list every day. I do not believe in the idea of making a timetable, get up at 5 a.m., start studying at 6 a.m., sit down till 8 a.m., then 8 to 8:30 breakfast. I don't believe in this because it is very difficult to follow. But when you make a to-do list, what is a to-do list? In which you write down things that you will be doing today. For example, today I'll be practicing 2 sectional tests of legal reasoning. Today I will be attending 4 classes. Today I will be reading the newspaper. Today I will be covering some current affairs that I have to revise. So when you write this down and keep ticking it, then you feel better that, okay, I am preparing well and my preparation is going to some place. Try this for at least 15 days and let me know in the comment section if it helps you. So, all right, guys, that is it. And I hope this was helpful for you. I hope to see you in the classes. Use code KRITIB if any of you wish to take the subscription on 12 Minutes to CLAT and attend the classes. And I shall hope to see you in the classes. थैंक यू सो मच एंड टेक केयर एंड हैव अ ग्रेट डे. और आपको जो चाहिए हो जिंदगी में आपको जरूर मिले. बाय.